Yeah. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
One of the most famous things Padre Pio said was, "Pray, hope, and don't worry." So tonight's Gospel is perfect to message Padre Pio to us. Jesus says, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God and have faith in me." Today was a day of tremendous grace and blessing and inspiration for our diocese. From the moment that the relics of Saint Pio were put on display at 9 a.m. with a special prayer service, to right now, there's been a steady stream of people all day long. Children, teenagers, young people, older people, people of every race, people from our diocese, people from places far away, patiently waiting in line to venerate the relics of this holy saint. And part of Padre Pio's appeal is that each one of us feels like he's just here for us, that he prays for us, that he's on our side, that he's a great intercessor for us before the throne of God. And that he lived in our own time. He died in 1968, 50 years ago, this year. And so we see in Pio, as we see in every saint, a replication of the whole drama of salvation, the life, death, and resurrection of Christ. Italians are obsessed with Padre Pio. When John Paul II canonized him, there were well over a million people at the Mass, going all the way down to the River Tiber. It was the most well-attended canonization Mass in the history of the Church. And so the spirit of Pio continues to fill the Church, and his intercession and his presence and his holiness continue to magnetize people. As impressive as it's been to have his relics with us today, something very deeply moving for me was simply watching the people come forward. And as I sat in church at various times today, people would come up to me and say, "Pray for me, I'm here because I just found out I have cancer. Or I'm really struggling in my marriage. Or I'm really worried about my kids. Or I have all these special intentions and then bring them to Padre Pio today and I know that he will take care of them." So what inspired me today is not only the life of Pio, but the faith of our people. Thousands of people coming here today, trusting that God loves them, that through the intercession of the saints, hope and power and grace will be given to us. And so today was a day of great blessing and inspiration for all of us. And we give thanks to God as we close this special day with the celebration of I want to thank the wonderful folks from the St. Pio Foundation who drove the relics here to Gary from La Crosse, Wisconsin, which is an arduous trek of over 5 hours. They came here last night. They've stayed here all day. I want to thank Father Dobrinsky and the people of our worship office who worked together on our liturgical celebration. So many people from the diocese that were here all day. A lot of work went into today, so I just thank everybody who helped in any way. When I think of St. Pio's life, it's clear that here is a soul that God chose from the beginning. Because even as a young boy, he already had visions of God and the angels of the saints. He already experienced Jesus. By the time he was 5 years old, he already clearly made up his mind that he wanted to live his life for God. I don't know when you were doing when you were 5 years old, but I don't think I was clearly set on a path to serve and please God in all things when I was 5. Other things go by a little while. But here's a soul that was chosen from the beginning. And he joins the Capuchins after a childhood of deep poverty and already suffering from hard work. It was in 1918 that he experienced the stigmata for the first time, that his hands and his feet were wounded with the wounds of Christ. And he lived with the pain of that until his death. Every moment, he was physically united to the passion of Christ. It was as if he was branded by the cross. And his whole life was this living sacrifice, this participation in the passion of Jesus. The mystical power of that is something that we can't even begin to grasp fully. What he lived every single day, life of deep suffering. He was also assaulted by the devil. Oftentimes in his cell at night, they would physically beat him up. And all the fighters can attest to the truth of that. They would want to come in and save him, and he said, "Don't come in, this is between Satan and me." But they would hear him being beaten at night. A life of deep suffering. There was a period in the 1940s and early 50s when certain leaders of the church were jealous of his popularity and succeeded in having him silenced. Where he couldn't celebrate public mass, he couldn't preach, his ministry was curtailed. He accepted all of that. Simply bowed to the will of the church, because he knew that nothing is ever lost by being obedient. When you're obedient, you can never go wrong, even if in the back of your mind you may question the decision that's made. He was radically obedient, a life of deep suffering. The other thing that stands out for me about St. Pio's life is his remarkable zeal for souls. He spent a great percentage of his time hearing confessions, like St. John Vianney. And like John Vianney, he had the gift of reading hearts, so if you didn't tell him all your sins, he'd fill in the details when you came into his confession. That'd be a little disarming, wouldn't it? But a great zeal for souls. People would send him money from all over the world, and he lived in southern Italy, which was very, very poor. That money and he built the best hospital, a state-of-the-art medical institution to take care of the sick and the poor and the needy. And that hospital still stands as a legacy of his charity. A great zeal for souls. Throughout his life, millions of people wrote him letters who, just like us, felt a personal connection to him. That he would read their letter and understand their situation and pray for them and know what to do. He attempted to answer every single one of those letters. So when you go to San Giovanni di Rotondo in Italy, in the friary there's an entire room that is simply filled with a sampling of the letters of people that wrote to him from all over the world. Here was a man, here was a priest, here was a stigmatist, here was a saint, whose entire life was consumed as a living flame to bring people to the Lord Jesus Christ. And sometimes that was a word of consolation. Sometimes it was a word of challenge. It was not always sweetness and light. And if you needed to be straightened out, St. Pio would tell you exactly what you needed to do to come to the Lord and to leave sin behind. His life then stands for us as a remarkable gift, as a remarkable legacy, but also as a challenge. Because what the Lord did for him, he's seeks to do for us. Not in terms of his extraordinary mystical gifts, but in the sense of a soul surrendered to the grace of Christ. Though what St. Paul said of himself in Galatians is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me, Pio lived that legacy of mystical union with Christ. And today, his message for us is the Lord wants that for us as well. Jesus wants to move and breathe and live and act in us as powerfully as he did in the life of St. Pio. And Jesus will do so to the extent that we give him permission, to the extent that we let him in, to the point of our surrender and our docility and our obedience. It's almost as if Jesus says, how far will you let me come into your life and take over so that you become an extension of my grace. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. In these relics of this man, we have this physical connection to a great saint who lived in our own time, and whose prayers and intercession stand for us before the throne of God. And so I offer this Mass for all of you and for your intentions. I offer this Mass for our diocese. I offer this Mass for our priests, our deacons, our religious, our seminarians, our lay faithful, all of us who seek to strive and live the holy gospel of Jesus. I offer this Mass that St. Pio, who is here in the spiritual communion of the saints, may continue to love us, pray for us, inspire us, and move us to eradicate from our lives sin, and to allow the grace of God to still take us over, that what St. Paul said will become radically true of us. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. I've always been struck by the fact that St. Pio could be in two places at once. And he went to St. Maria Coretti's canonization in Rome, all the while that he was at the friar. And when somebody commented on that, he simply smiled and he didn't give an answer. People would have apparitions of him when they were in the middle of accidents, middle of fires, middle of great danger. Suddenly this brown robed capuchin would show up and intervene and save them. And he would disappear. So all the while that he was at his friar, he was wandering around the world doing good. Today, he wanders around the world, he wanders around the church, he wanders around our hearts, seeking to do the good that he can from his vantage point before the throne of the glory of God. We have this great friend, this great intercessor, this great inspiration, this man, this priest, this brother of ours, who simply wants us to one day be what he is, in complete union with Jesus, before the throne of God for another. St. Pio, pray for us.
Prayer, the key that opens the heart of God to the Lord.
may be strengthened to radiate the mystery of the cross and to persevere in ceaseless prayer, confident that God knows what we need even before we ask. To the Lord we pray.
Christ graciously hear us.
O Lord Jesus Christ, with words of your kingdom, with fire of your love and many hearts, renew the sin of hearts for the passion of the body of Saint Pio of Pietrelcina. Mercifully grant that with the help of his merits and intercession, we may bear the cross without faltering and bring forth fruits of the living of the gospel, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For it is in your providence and purpose to form your saints in the likeness of Christ, and manifest through you in them your presence and your likeness. As we contemplate the life and witness of Saint Pio, he calls us to seek more earnestly your city that is to come. And we behold in him the trusted way that leads to the blessed union of Christ. Now as we celebrate his memory, we join the host of angels and saints in their exalted hymn of praise.
For the forgiveness of sins, do this in memory of me.
consider holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spouse, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with serene, kindly countenance, and to accept them. As once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant, able to just, sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of our high priest, Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask the Lord God, the man who is initially born by the hands of the holy angel, to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation of the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants, who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who are sinners, hoping that upon the mercy, graciously grant us to share in fellowship with the holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. And meet us with receiving to their company, no waiting on merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Thank you. Lord, to thee,
as we give our thanks after communion, what we have such a collection taken up, and all the money given to go to the St. Pio Foundation, which shares these generous folks to continue to bring the relics of St. Pio around the world, and we thank you all for tonight as a gift of the work of the St. Pio Foundation. Also, I want to say a special word of prayer thanks to our friends and families who faithfully stood vigil throughout the day throughout the visitation of the relics. And thank you for dancing. Let us pray. Grant, we beseech you, O Lord, through the holy gifts which we have received, that by imitating the apostolic charity and zeal of St. Pio, we may experience the effect of your charity and form ourselves in love for all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just pray, Lord, be seated for a moment. I'd like to offer a special blessing relics to our religious, and invite all our religious people forward, as well as all our seminaries from our diocese, and seminaries from the Legionary of Christ School in Holy Prayer, and just invite you to come forward. This fall, our Diocese of Gary will have 16 seminaries, 10 new seminaries that are being accepted in addition to the 6 that we have. I just want to say a special word of thanks and praise to Guadalupe and our vocations team. So please continue to pray for vocations, because we need everyone to live the vocation, but we still need many and holy priests to serve our people, and especially to preach the gospel. So what great joy that gives us as we see our number of seminaries increase to 16. So we ask us to continue to pray for these, our religious, our seminaries, and we ask his apostolic zeal and his holiness may be yours as you live the evangelical principles of poverty, chastity, and release. Let us pray. Lord God, I ask that you bless these servants of yours, that like St. Pio, as they have left all to follow you, you may give them sufficient grace to be faithful in their vocation. Thank you for their yes, for their commitment to your grace and to your calling. And I ask this blessing of Father, Son, and your Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you for your gracious yes, for your witness to Christ. Many thanks to all of you for being here with us. More than you need.